Megatron here. Welcome to the Buzz. Tonight we're coming out of Melbourne, the home of burnt steak. And tonight we are burning the beef like you wouldn't believe. We're here at Echo Unlimited's Battle Royale number 2. An incredibly huge breakdancing competition that sees the cream of Queensland's breakdancing scene, the Rapid Fire Breakers, take on Victoria's ultimate spinning on their head people, the Wicked Force Breakers. It's going to be a huge night of head-to-head breaking that we're going to be bringing you, plus head-to-head scratching DJing action. There might be a bit of graffiti. Then we're going graffiti the place that burnt the steaks. So we're going to be explaining, well, not explaining because we can't do that, but bringing you lots of breaking hip-hop action on the Buzz. It's the last Buzz of the year, so we're kind of save the best till last. Here's a bit of action from the night right now.
Well, a very privileged thing has happened there, viewers. We've been allowed into the warm-up facility area, change room of the Wicked Force Breakers from Melbourne. Are you feeling hot tonight? Are you gonna cream them? That's a bit better. They're a little mellow before. Too much chanting and prayers and stuff. Now, A1 is joining us, and you might remember, if you've been watching the show, which is a good thing to do, is watch the show, you would have seen A1 and the whole kind of milk bar stories. Do you remember the... Yeah. Your first, well, it probably wasn't your first TV experience,
no,
was it?
No, of course not.
It was. We took your TV virginity. We stole it.
No, I've done some other stuff before that, but it was a pretty cool thing. I was pretty surprised at what you did with that, turning it into a documentary. You know, making me a bit of a star.
Is it led to a bit of contention amongst the other breakers in the crew?
We want more footage, man, of us.
Oh.
There was a lot of footage, but it was a last minute thing. Like, you guys came, you know, and gave me a call and said, yeah, we'll be down there, we'll film a bit of stuff. Dion was involved, do you remember Dion? He was in the video.
Please. Are we allowed to say Dion's name?
You ruined my identity.
That's fine, it doesn't bother me.
That's fine.
But I was
there
too.
Breeze.
He's a bit quick.
Now, exit, is exit in here or exit's in the other crew?
No, exit's rapid fire.
That seems to be such a... Oh, I obviously won't be saying this to his face, but, you know, kind of...
Coming in with a big exit.
You've done your bit and off you go. Let's take a look at George in action. A1! Not George. I don't know any George here right now. Here's A1 in action from earlier in the year. Go, A1!
Tonight, everybody's flying down for it. We've got guys from Sydney, guys from Brisbane coming down, and we're representing Melbourne, Australia.
George, he's the OG of breaking. He's been doing it for so many years. I remember we used to be at clubs and he'd be mucking around and everyone would be dissing him, like literally. And like he'd be saying, yeah, yeah, yeah. He loves it. It's like it's coming from within.
I've loved it. And I love it. It's my life. I love it. All I think about at night are moves, air moves, flying. I love it. Melbourne hasn't seen a battle like this probably in about 14 to 16 maybe years. They haven't seen a battle like this one, so...
And we've never had to excel people have to tonight.
Yeah.
See, George and I, we've known each other for quite a few years, and I think we've both been, I rate myself equal with George. I think he's got a lot of qualities, and I've got qualities. So it's going to be very tough, I think.
There's a lot of rumours going around that who is and who isn't the best. So what we did as Echo was send an airline ticket to all those that thought they were the best, and they're here tonight to give it up and show everyone who is.
Breeze!
Benny.
And one, two.
Jura?
What?
Exit. Different.
Did my C's?
Why? In the house!
They were good. Like, we come to anything and yeah, you know, fucking, what's going on? But yeah, we were surprised, man. They rocked it, yeah, really good. All of
them. You saw him earlier sweeping the shop. Now look at him. Can't even sweep himself. We all tried our hardest. It's all that matters, mate. We all did good. We had a good time. It was all worth it.
Rapid Fire featuring on stage B-Boy Bass from the B-Boy All-Stars, 14 years experience, Australia's number one B-Boy. Ladies and gentlemen, standing next to B-Boy Bass is one of the Moulton brothers from Rapid Fire. Exit, give it up. Yeah, and from the Cyberforce crew, joining with Rapid Fire tonight to challenge Wicked Force, the long-platted Flare Master, Kid Rock!
Give it up!
Second twin, also founding member of Rapid Fire, the one, the only, B-Boy Seas! And on the end, making up the second half of Cyberforce, joining forces with Rapid Fire tonight. Rely, give it up, Melbourne, for Rapid Fire. Another one bites the dust. And gentlemen, on stage tonight, the Wicked Force, up front with the band. Quickly. Yeah, joining the Wicked Force for the first time tonight here in Victoria, all the way from Italy, the Italian Stallion, Duke. Sporting a brand new haircut, new style, trust no man, walks. In the middle, the master of disaster, faster than all, new G-Force, the Turtle. Old school, new school, true school, Duel. Shocking you all with a 3D pop, smooth style American headband on the end, Breeze. Ladies and gentlemen, the sixth member of Wicked Force, George A. One.
Yo, man, you're fighters. All your homeboys are fighters.
We're psyching here with the Rapid Firebreakers from Brisbane, here in the kind of strange surrounds. They've travelled to Melbourne, and this is their dressing room. Now, who is who?
Okay, I'm B-Boy C's.
B-Boy C's.
Kid Rock.
B-Boy Bask.
Rely One. And Exit.
Exit! That is, now you've got a sign over there that's going to be held up later.
Yeah, I write my name everywhere, and that's just
an example. Yeah, they're sort of promoting me, more or less, you know.
Breaking the competitive thing, is the rivalry, is there a lot of rivalry between the two crews tonight?
I think a lot more fun,
to be honest.
Really?
Yeah, a lot more fun, yeah, I think that's important, but like, your rivalry is good as well, but
yeah.
This time it's more fun, I think.
Oh, that's cool.
It's a lot of fun.
Was the first time a bit more head-to-head kind of thing.
Yeah, it's a bit more of a standoff last time. We didn't know who was going at first. Everyone's standing there, you know, and pressure was building, and you know, until someone broke, it was just like...
A bit more blood, we hope. A bit more blood tonight.
Yeah, I'm hoping for a bit of blood.
Lots of guts. Lots of guts, yeah.
What's the big injury that people at home that might be inspired by your breaking tonight, that they give it a shot? What's the big thing to look out for?
Breaking neck's a good one. You're the one to try breaking it, yeah.
Does that happen often?
Oh, not to us, but probably the people at home, it may, you know.
Don't try it. That was the big rumour with Gary Coleman or Emmanuel Lewis. Remember the guy Webster? He broke his neck rap dancing.
There was heaps of those, yeah.
You should always make sure you've got a strong neck and good balance before you even try it, because if, you know, it's just like trying to ballet dance if you've got no technability. So.
Yeah, practice those headstands on the grass for a while.
Do you need a helmet before you can spin on your head?
Not necessarily. You can spin on your bare head, but a helmet's advisable.
If you'd like to get a bald patch, go without the helmet. If you've got a bald patch, you know, go without the helmet, you'll be right. There's no shortcuts, especially with breaking, you know, like some of the other things, you can either bomb crazy and get respect by just hitting heaps of trains or something like that, where I was like little camera tricks or whatnot, but breaking, you know, there's no shortcut. You've got to practice and you have to practice. Yeah, there's no...
You see tonight, like, yeah. You know, we've trained for, you know, 10 years, most of us to do some things we want to do.
Yeah,
a lot of hard
each
work.
Each move takes
like a long time to perfect, like it's not something you get overnight, so you'll see people doing combinations of moves, and each move that they've done has taken like years or so to perfect and get down.
I've got to get my head around this. I'm going to go and study. You guys have to warm up and flex.
Yeah, we do.
We better let you go and do that. Yeah, thanks for talking to us, Rapid Fire Breakers. Yeah. Are you going to win tonight?
Yeah.
Well, I'm cheering for both camps. Take the trophy home.
I know everyone out there in Queensland is like, they're going for us. I know Queensland's looking out.
We're doing this for you.
Go the Maroons.
Yes.
Good luck.
Directional windmill. Yeah.
You're gagging. Try to tell yourself that you need a lift. Make a couple of lines.
The boss is Kid Rock.
Snip your world away. Snip your girl away. Snip your life away. Snip your wife away. Snip your money, your gold, and your friends. Your credit card is not very hard. Once you start, it never end. Blast off, hands on the throttle. Basing, chasing genius in a bottle. Make a wish, but don't say it out loud. Cause all you're gonna gain is pain in another crowd.
Hi, I'm A1 and I'm from the Wicked Force Breakers, and we have got
Breeze in the house on the steps of Parliament on this beautiful day in Melbourne. We also have
G-Force from Wicked Force Breakers.
DJ Perilous representing Wicked Force, baby.
Johnny Jewel One, King of Barman, King of Breaking, and King of everything else.
Down there, G.
I'm a Duke, I'm come from Italy, I'm really glad to breakdance with Wicked Force.
Wow, tonight.
Tonight's the night. There's gonna be a war, baby.
Tonight's the night of all nights. We, Wicked Force, are taking on Rapid Fire, which is a crew from Brisbane. There's five breakers that are coming down. We've had one battle already, which was at, what was the club called?
Revolver.
At Revolver in Chapel Street.
Revolver.
And there was no winner declared, so we've had another one. Echo and Metro put this on for us.
We know who the winner was.
So we've got another battle, so apparently the public wanted a winner. So now we've got four judges, two from Melbourne, I think two from Brisbane, if that's right.
I think there's an extra one from a judge from Sydney. Right. I think it might be Trent Roden, I'm not sure. Right.
So we've got like four or five judges, so tonight there has to be a winner. So the boys are coming down about 6 o'clock tonight, and Metro put on a stage for us and a bit of a setup. So for us, this is the biggest deal. We're all breakers, we've all been breaking and friends for a long time, but for us, this is do or die, you know. If we lose, it's a bit of like, you know, egg on face kind of thing.
Yeah,
this is it, this is our big moment. And whoever wins this battle, whether it's them or us, is going to be the best in Australia, the best crew in Australia at this moment. And hopefully, I think there's rumours that later maybe the two crews will get together, get the best of the two crews, get a crew of about five or six members and take on, I think, a crew from America. I think they might be flying out a crew. So that's what's happening today, and that's what this is all about. The name itself was probably even earlier, probably 86. Like you said, we've all been on and off, but George here has been the main stayer. He's the one that's kept up with it and kept training. And hopefully tonight that will shine and that will show.
Yeah, boy! I'm gonna go!
As much as it's a crew effort and a team effort, George here is our man. And if he performs, we perform, you know what I mean? And if he doesn't perform, well, then he gets slapped and he gets kicked out.
I trained so much in Tasmania, like I was, you know, really hyped up about the battle. I just kept training for hours to train. And just at the last show that we did, I think it was on Saturday night, I felt, you know, my wrist give way a bit. And after the show, like, I felt really sore. And then that night, I accidentally slept on it, making it even worse, numbing it, waking up, and my hand was just throbbing. I thought, oh no, what am I gonna do? Like, seriously, I was in tears. I rang up Steve, I go, Steve, what are we gonna do? He goes, don't worry, I'll hook it up.
We'll go to a doctor. I've got an injection now. I can't feel a thing. My wrist is fine. Yeah, boy.
No, I'm fine with injuries because, you know, I stretch and do all the right things. No, really. No, I'm fine. But I know another member's got a bit of an injury. Tell us about it, John Jay.
The back. The front. The leg. The elbow. The wrist. The neck. Even the ankle.
He should be in hospital.
I'm 28, I'm 29 on Saturday, and I feel the effects of breakdancing. Many years ago, I was forced to retire. Now, my honor is at stake. I was the master. I will be the master. Rapid fire, look out. I'm coming. Now.
Wicked Force is G-Force!
Mr. Electric Boogaloo Part 2, Steve Douglas from Kiss FM. He's also from Echo Unlimited, also the brains behind this whole affair. Where did you come up with the whole Grand Royale head-to-head breaking rumble affair?
Watching lots of WWF videos.
It seems to have that feel idea about it, the wrestling.
Yeah,
the
what we wanted to do rather than a nightclub-based event, DJ sort of typical MC thing. We wanted a more WWF feel, more like a athletic event or a competition. Like the caged wrestling thing, you know, Hulk Hogan meets Andre the Giant and kicks his sorry butt.
They just had this thing recently, 20 or 60 men, yeah, three rings, one survivor.
That's what Battle Royale's about. It's kind of, we've even got the showgirls doing the intros for the rapid fire. We've got the girls in the men's gallery. Props to the men's gallery.
Love them. We'll be heading down after the show.
Yeah. we wanted to give that for the intro feel. It's more about a competition than a nightclub, disco-y, beer-drinking thing. This guy.
Has it been done before? Competitiveness seems to be a big part of the breaking scene.
In this country, this is the single biggest event this country's ever seen. And we were talking today, because a couple of guys have toured the world two, three times, and the highest regarded event is Radiotron. And this is quite possibly bigger than that. The staging, sound, effort, press in this is probably four or five times what Radiotron would be.
It's a huge looking setup, the robotic light kind of arms and stuff.
All that's kind of, you know, nice light incidental, light. But the stage out there is a specific B-boy stage. You know, we put a, it's a sprung floor, dead level, blah, 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 specific surface for them.
Is there a little rivalry between these two crews?
Yeah, heaps.
In sport and stuff, all states hate each other.
It's like state of origin. This is it. This is
bashing people in wheelchairs.
Oh, well, there's no rapid fire here. They're down in the
where. Keep them away. Keep
yeah, absolutely. This event probably is happening now too, because these guys have only got to this standard now. There's no one on this stage tonight less than 10 years experience, and there's guys on the stage 14 years experience, and it's taken them that long, and worldwide, the standard of breaking has got to its point that it is now because of the time that people have been doing it. It takes that long to nail these moves and get these combinations running. And we're very close to getting people like Air Force Crew, Ivan, all the legends of the nation. They're all starting to look here because the power moves here are world class. Power moves are all the aerial, all the spectacular stuff that freaks the crowd out. World class. George now from Wicked Force, A1, they're now talking about him as best in the world. You know, we don't know until we go up against everyone else. But if they're starting to have these conversations and people start talking this way, the standard is very high.
Yeah, B-Boy sees! Ladies and gentlemen, this is not much fun at all. It's a split decision.
Oh, sexy baby, straight, shake the ass, baby. Woo, show some leg.
I gotta say thanks to Jabba from Foxtel. Thanks to Andre from Hardcore. Thanks from Anna Kim from Biatch. Thanks to Paris from Whirlwind. It's a tough decision. Two split, left up to me to make the final decision.
And thanks to John Travolta over there, baby. Staying alive.
Wicked Force, come get your trophy!
I think the winners might be in here. Ah, oh, Wicked Force! There's no cheering! It's all gone quiet!
Hey! It's all been done!
George, are there cheers? Is there cheering? A1? It's all very mellow here.
What's up?
Oh, that's better. That's what we expect! Where's the trophy? Why aren't you like parading it round, just kind of ejaculating all over it? Oh, the trophy. Oh. Can I hold it? Can I touch it?
I'd like to thank my mum. But then. Nah. I'd like to say a few things. I'd first like to thank Steve Douglas for helping putting all of this together. Without him, it couldn't have been possible. I'd like to thank Rapid Fire and Wicked Force for the best fucking battle ever. Thank you very much. Tonight, the only winner was Breakin', man. The only real winner was Breakin'. We showed it's more than a fad, more than bullshit. It's skillful fucking demonstration of martial art-like talent. Woo! We make gymnasts look like puppets.
Yeah, this is Rapid Fire. Don't worry about that.
Don't worry about anything. This is Rapid Fire. They are just... Are you pulling together after the... Well, I mean, no one really lost because no one could fairly say that one crew was better than the other crew, but the other crew got the trophy. I mean, it's just a lump of plastic.
Home crowd favourite, exactly.
And they had an extra member.
Yeah, they had an extra member, which was harder.
But don't have sour grapes. No. Do you need to kind of...
Someone had to win, you know, and it's good. They had to choose. Someone had to win. We couldn't go up with a draw again, you know. You had to at least somebody wins. And next time, the challengers come back next time and blah, blah, blah.
And Steve, they're making the last-minute split-second decision, probably avoiding the hometown riot there. So what's next? Is there another head-to-head that you've got in the pipeline coming up, or it's back to training kind of thing?
Back to training stuff. There's a lot of work. We're still doing a lot of stuff. But, like, I think everyone wants to thank Steve for putting this sort of shit on, because without it, you know, this is like big events for Australia. Like, we'll go back in history.
Yeah, it's a good thing. Next time it's Australia versus Europe or America. Yeah. We'll go overseas and take them on. Yeah?
Wow, that would be cool.
Yeah, it's good to see Aussie breakers getting together and ready to compete overseas as we're all ready, as you can see.
So maybe it would be a combined national team of Wicked Force and Rapid Fire guys.
That'd be great. Yeah.
Excellent. All right, we'll go and have photos and drink beers and relax and polish their helmets. That was awesome. Rapid Fire!
It's DJ Pearl bringing up the old school beat. This is George, A1 from the Wicked Force. Give it up, Melbourne!
We're going 70s, baby! Pimp strutting, baby!
Oh, my God.